Thanks, Norman. Hi, everybody. The Bill of Rights Defense Committee and Defending Dissent Foundation is a now almost 60-year-old organization that is dedicated to ensuring that the promise of the Bill of Rights is fulfilled for everyone, which is a long fight. So we need this torture report to be released. When he decided not to hold accountable Bush administration torturers, President Obama urged us to look forward, not back. And now we are looking forward, and we're worried, frightened, horrified at what we see, an incoming administration of men so depraved and ignorant that they openly proclaim their support for torture. These men need to read the torture report, and we need that torture report to be made public so that we can call out their lies and misrepresentations that torture works, that it isn't that bad, or that what was done in our name was not torture. We know Trump is morally vacant, and he's nominated a team of men who will back him up on that. Just take a look at Jeff Sessions, who has consistently failed to oppose torture. He was one of only 9 members of the U.S. Senate to vote against a 2005 amendment barring cruel, inhuman, and degrading treatment of detainees in U.S. custody. And again, in 2015, Sessions voted against torture prohibitions when he voted against holding the FBI and CIA to the same standards of interrogation laid out in the U.S. Army Field Manual, which forbids torture. So just think about that for a minute. Jeff Sessions is willing to give the FBI agents free rein to do what we don't even allow our armed forces to do on a battlefield. Mike Pompeo, nominated to be the director of the CIA, has doggedly opposed the release of the Senate torture report. In 2014, he said, quote, "These men and women are not torturers, they're patriots." Not in my book. Pompeo has also fought against closing Guantanamo. And although it isn't true, he has alleged that, quote, Gitmo has been a gold mine of intelligence about radical Islamic terrorism, end quote. And despite the lack of charges, indefinite detention, and horrible conditions that led prisoners to stage a prolonged hunger strike, which then resulted in gruesome, cruel, inhumane, and torturous force feeding of these prisoners, Pompeo has maintained that, quote, the detainees at Gitmo are treated exceptionally well, so well that some have even declined to be resettled, instead choosing to stay at Gitmo, end quote. President Obama and Senator Feinstein, we implore you to release the torture report so that we have a fighting chance to keep our country from going back and declaring torture official policy. Thank you.